Thank you, Lord
Jesus.
Father, for all your young sons and daughters, Lord Father, Amen. Who have given their heart to you, Lord Father. Father God, we pray in the name of Jesus, Lord, that Father, Spirit of God, you take control of this water baptism, Lord. Father God, in the day of Pentecost, Lord Father, you have sent that wind, Lord Father. Father God, we pray in the name, same name, in the same name, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Father, tonight, Lord Father, we sprinkle, Lord Father, the blood of Jesus upon every son and daughter, Lord Father. Father God, we give their mother and father into their hand, Lord Father. Father God, we know, Lord Father, when two of you gather in thy name, Lord, you are present, Lord Father. We thank you, Lord, for Holy Spirit of God is here, Lord Father.
Amen.
Lord, we thank you, Lord, that we welcome you in this
Hallelujah.
Place, Lord.
And
we give you glory, honor, and praise, Father God, for hearing
thank
our
you, Lord.
Lord.
Thank
Father,
you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Today we believe, Lord Father, the heaven is going to rejoice.
Amen.
Their names are going to be written in the book of life, Lord Father. Amen. We thank you, Lord, that you have heard our prayer, Lord. You are going to answer their prayer, Lord. And Father, from today onwards, Lord, they will never turn back, Lord Father. Father God, the riches of this world, the fear of the society will be never there, Lord. Father God, we thank you, Lord, every fear from their life will be null and void, Lord.
Amen.
We cover them from the top of our head to the very feet of our soul. The Bible says, Father, you're not going to leave us, nor forsaken us, Lord. Father, we thank you for your promises, yes and amen, Lord. Father God, the heaven and earth will pass away, Lord, but your word will remain, Lord, Father. We thank you, Lord, for the word of Jesus Christ. We thank you, Lord, for the holy word. And we know, Lord, Father, you're going to establish them. You're going to lift them up from today onwards. Lord.
Amen.
Father God, the Bible says, when one person is saved in the family, this entire household is saved, Lord. Father God, we thank you, Lord, also unsaved family members also will come to know the salvation, Lord. Father God, we thank you. We give you all the glory, honor, and praise, Lord, for hearing and answering our prayer, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray and ask.
Amen. Amen. Remember one important thing. This, you're not doing it for any denomination. You're not doing it for me. You're not doing it for your parents. You're not doing it for your society or priests, pastors, leaders, or anybody. You are doing it for your own soul, which is connected to God the Father.
Amen.
You are showing your love for what Jesus died on the cross of Calvary and paid the penalty, saying that I paid all your penalty. Your sin is paid, your death is paid, your sickness, your curses, everything I paid. And you say today, I bury my old nature and I come back to you like you, Jesus Christ, and you obey and dedicate your life to Jesus Christ, all right? So that is what is very, very important. Number one, the Bible clearly says, we are going to read Acts chapter 8, verse 38.
And he commanded the chariot to stand still, and they both went down into the water, both Philip and the eunuch, and he baptized him. And when they were come up out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord caught away Philip, that the eunuch saw him no more, and he went on his way rejoicing.
The Bible speaks about here, as you are giving the gospel, as soon as anybody hears, they should obey. But good, you have taken little time to understand the scriptures. Now you are dedicating your life for the water baptism, and that's very nice. The Bible clearly says, what is the meaning of baptism? Baptism means one has to go down in the water. Baptism means it's an act of going down in the liquid. But we don't go down in the oil. We don't go down in a muddy oil or anything. We go down under the water. So therefore the Bible clearly says it's an act of going down in the water. So Romans chapter 6, verses 5, 6, 7.
For if we have been planted together in the likeness of his death, we shall also in the likeness of his resurrection. Knowing this, that our old man is crucified with him, that the body of sin might be destroyed, that henceforth we should not serve sin.
And verse 7 says,
for he that is dead is freed from sin.
He that is dead is free from sin.
Amen.
So the Bible says, water baptism signifies that one has to die himself. But we are not dying that physical death, but we are dying the spiritual death. So spiritually, with the physical health, we are burying ourselves into the water. That represents the death of Jesus on the cross of Calvary, the burial of Jesus Christ in the tomb, and third day, resurrection of Jesus Christ from the tomb. That represents. But when you do it in the water, it tells the word of God says that you are burying your old nature. You are burying your old man. You are burying your old sinful nature, and you are coming up with the Holy Spirit of God up. You are becoming a new man, a new woman. Nobody is, except Brother Ernest, everybody is single here. No, it's a sister. But you all are going to be a powerful men and women.
Amen.
Your life is not going to be like that.
Amen.
Amen. When you come up from the water, you come up with the power of God.
Amen.
You come up with the Holy Spirit of God, and your life shall be victorious and successful. Are you ready to say amen?
Amen.
Number two, the Bible says it identifies the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. Colossians chapter 2, verse 12. 2 verse 12 says it also identifies the death, one person's death, burial, and resurrection. Who is that person? The one who is taking in the water baptism. It identifies his death, his burial, with the death and burial and resurrection of Jesus Christ our Lord. Colossians chapter 2, verse 10, 11, 12.
And ye are complete in him, which is the head of all principality and power, in whom also ye are circumcised with the circumcision made without hands, in putting off the body of the sins of the flesh by the circumcision of Christ, buried with him in baptism, wherein also ye are risen with him through the faith of the operation of God, who had raised him from the dead.
So you bury yourself in the water, and you raise yourself in the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Same thing the Bible says in Colossians chapter 3. Colossians chapter 3 says, you are burying yourself, your old nature, old sinful nature, old man, old carnal mind, old carnal body, and old carnal things. You are burying yourself, and you are resurrecting in the presence of God Almighty with the power of the Holy Spirit of God. Same thing, Galatians chapter 3 says. 2 Corinthians chapter 5. And I always tell you, whenever you read Corinthians, you remember Paul. Paul is always writing wonderful letters to the church of Corinthians. He wants to encourage. Today I feel that he wants to encourage all of you with the power. He says that you are doing great work. You are doing this work for Jesus Christ. And he also says, verse 16, 17, and 18, 2 Corinthians chapter 5.
Wherefore henceforth know we no man after the flesh. Though we have known Christ after the flesh, yet now henceforth know we.
You have understood Jesus Christ when you are living in the flesh. But no more you are going to live in the flesh. Then the Bible says, verse 17, Therefore,
if any man be in Christ, he is a new creation.
If any man is in Christ, he is a new creation.
All things are passed away.
All things are going to be passed away from your life. Old nature, sinful activities, all manner of anger, evil hopes, unwanted things to see, talk about it. It has to go. It has to go away. All the old nature which brings sin in my life and your life must go. And then you should walk in the newness of life. The next word.
Behold, all things are become new.
All things are become new. Verse 18 and 19. 18.
And all things are God reconciled us by Jesus Christ, and have given to us the ministry of reconciliation.
Remember, this thing is not of society, man and woman and any denomination. This is all things of God. You are doing the things of God. And when you are doing the things of God, you are getting the power of God, Holy Spirit of God in you. You are going to become a new creation. The Bible clearly says, Ephesians chapter 2, 10. There also the Bible clearly says, it identifies one's death, burial, and resurrection. It identifies one sinful nature is getting buried. Old man is getting buried in the water, and he is becoming new. She is becoming new with the power of the Holy Spirit. No more she's old. No more he walks into the old nature, but walking in the newness of God. Bible clearly says in Acts chapter 2, verse 37, 38, 39. Acts chapter 2, verse 37, 38, 39. I will just give you the short information.
Now, when they heard this, they were pricked in their heart, and said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles, Men and brethren, what shall we do? Then Peter said unto them, Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit.
The Bible says Peter was preaching the gospel to all the people around here and there. Paul also was doing. When Peter was preaching, many people got convicted in their hearts. And they were saying, now what shall we do? Then Peter told them, now since you are convicted with the word of God, and your heart is telling you to do what you should do according to the will of God, then better that you should be able to understand, you confess your sins, you repent for your sins, you take the word of God, become a new man, a new woman. That's what Peter was telling. And then at the end of the day, in this Acts of 2, it says that it signifies outward testimony of inward conviction. This is your outward testimony that you are going and taking the word of baptism. But this is a conviction inside in your heart. You are convicted that Jesus paid the penalty of my sin. Jesus died on the cross of Calvary. Jesus was buried in the tomb. Jesus rose again on the third day. And Jesus also took the word of baptism through John the Baptist. I will do it. That is your outward actually conviction. And the Bible says, and the outward expression of inward decision. You made a decision inward. Anybody forced you, brother? What about you, sister? Sister, what is it? Shana, has anybody forced you? What about Sneha? Tell me your name.
Rian.
Okay, anybody? Of course, nobody must have forced you except them, that Pastor Vincent.
No.
Sure?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah, no.
Yes, sir. Nobody forced you. It means such a good decision. Come on, give a big hand of praise to the Lord. Such a good decision that you have communicated to the word of the Lord. Bible clearly says it will save your soul. It will save you from all wickedness. It will save you from sinful nature. It will save your soul, spirit, and body. Anytime when you go away from this earth, you're not going to go away anywhere. You are going to go away in a better kingdom. The kingdom of God forever and ever.
Amen.
You will not perish. The Bible says, who must obey the word of God? And 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 18, 19, 20, 21. Okay, 20, 21. 1 Peter chapter 2, 20, 21. 19, 20, 21.
For this is thankworthy, if a man for conscience toward God endure grief, suffering wrongfully. For what glory is it if, when he be buffeted for your faults, he shall take it patiently? But if, when you do well and suffer for it, you take it patiently, this is acceptable with God. For even hereunto were you called, because Christ also suffered for us, leaving us an example that you should follow his steps.
The Bible says you are following the example of whom? Whom? Christ. Because he also suffered. When John said, no, I will not drink the water after. He said, suffer to me. Let it be to fulfill all righteousness. Jesus, the Son of the living God, he doesn't need any water baptism. He doesn't need righteousness. But he said, let it be. It fulfills all righteousness. And he obeyed. So the Bible clearly says, Christ has given us the example. And that is the greatest example. Behind that example, you don't need any other example. You don't need to think, whether this belongs to Pentecost, or this belongs to Lutheran, Marthabite, Jacobite, Catholics, Roman Catholic. They're not taking, I should not take. No. You just look at Jesus Christ, because your focus is Jesus Christ, our Lord. Because he paid the penalty of your sin, my sin, our curses, our death, and therefore you focus to Jesus Christ, our Lord. And when you focus that, you can understand he gave you the example that he also took it through John the Baptist. Acts chapter 18, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, say amen, all of you.
Amen.
And the Bible clearly says, who can believe? The grown-up can believe. Child cannot believe. Child cannot repent. The grown-up can believe, grown-up can repent, grown-up can understand who has died on the cross of Calvary, but the child cannot. Even if you have taken just for to become a family member of the Christian family, Christian faith, according to some denomination, but yet you have to come into the knowledge of Christ to take the full immersion of water baptism, because that is for the grown-up one who can repent for his sins or her sins, who can understand how Jesus died on the cross of Calvary. And not only that, what will happen to you when you accept it? That's what is the Bible says. This is for the adult, grown-up people who can understand and who can realize. Bible clearly says why we must obey. This is the final thing, and then we are going to lead you into the prayers. Okay? Why we must obey. First reading, the Bible says, who must then obey the word of action, full image of word of action. Matthew chapter 28, verses 19 to 20.
Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world.
Why one must obey? Why we have to obey? Because it's a command of God. God commanded, go and preach the gospel, teach the gospel. That's what Jesus gave the commission. Number two, Acts chapter 19, verses 3 and 4.
He said unto them, unto what then we be baptized? And they said, unto John the Baptist. John the Baptist. Then said Paul, John verily baptized with the baptism of repentance, saying unto the people that they should believe on him which should come.
Why we must obey the word of baptism? Because it is the baptism of repentance. John taught us to repent. Peter also said to repent. Paul said, you must get the word of baptism because you can be filled with the Holy Spirit of God. So Peter, and as well as Acts of Apostles verses 19, Paul, and also Jesus Christ, they said it's the baptism of repentance. You are repenting for the old nature, old sin, whatever you have done it, probably in religion practices, probably personal life, all for that. This is the baptism of repentance. Matthew chapter 3, verse 10 and 11.
And now also the axe is laid unto the root of the trees. Therefore,
Every tree which bringeth not forth good fruit is hewn down and cast into the fire. I indeed baptize you with the water unto the repentance, but the he that cometh after me is mightier than I, whose shoes I am not worthy to bear, and he shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire.
The Bible says, number one, this is the command of God to take the water baptism. Number two, it's a baptism of repentance. Number three, in Matthew chapter 3, verse 10 and 11, it says it's a baptism of repentance, but to receive the Holy Spirit of God in your life. When you go down, when you come up, you're coming with the Holy Spirit. Matthew chapter 3, verse 16 and 17.
And Jesus, when he was baptized, went up straightway out of the water, and lo, the heavens were opened unto him. And he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and lighting up upon him.
The Bible clearly says when you obey, and as Jesus went down into the water, came up, he received the Holy Spirit of God, so also you will receive the Holy Spirit of God. And the heavens were opened, and God the Father spoke, this is my beloved Son, in whom I am
well pleased.
And today God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit is going to speak about you and what they are going to say. This is our beloved Son. This is our beloved Son and daughter. We are very much pleased. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit will speak about. The next word, Mark chapter 16, 15 and 16, the final thing.
Then he said unto them, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved.
Those who are taking this baptized, you are guaranteed you are saved. And you have to keep that, you know, eternal blessings of saving grace of God by walking according to the word, praying according to the word, keeping yourself righteous and keeping yourself holy. As we all are doing, coming to the word of God, coming in the, you know, sanctuary, having the fellowship, praying there, confessing our sins, repenting for our sins. We are also praising God, worshipping God, and accepting, you know, all the blessings that God gave us, and also the Holy Communion. So you have to continue to do that. The next thing, 17th verse.
But he that believeth not shall be damned.
But he that does not believe will be condemned. Today there are so many people, those who say, I am Christian. Some of them are actually challenging with me. They are saying, I am very strong Christian. But if you are a strong Christian and when God is saying something, why you are not obeying them? Then you are a religious man of the earth. Religion man of the earth cannot go to the kingdom of God. Therefore the Bible clearly teaches, what it teaches, believer,
is baptized shall be saved.
So you are saving your own soul, your own soul, your own soul, your own soul. The final thing is very, very important. The Bible clearly says, everyone those have taken this filmation of water baptism, trusting in Lord Jesus Christ and I, shall enter into the kingdom of God. Your names are going to be written today.
Amen.
There is already great rejoicing is going on in the kingdom of God.
Amen.
Yes, you are coming to the Christ. You are coming to Christ who has paid the penalty of your sin, your curse, and your death. Your soul is going to be rejoicing already there. Already God has started working through Jesus Christ our Lord, preparing a great mansion for you, a house for you, great mansion, mansion in the name of
Jesus.
Now is the time to repent. And I'm just guiding you for repentance. And I'm also doing the repentance with you. Because repentance is not only today. It's throughout your life it's going to be. Throughout your life you're going to repent. Whenever you sin, whenever you fall in weaknesses, whenever you are fallen down in any problems and troubles, this flesh is weak. If you go to the grave, there will be sin in this flesh. So repentance must continue in our life. And repentance will keep you holy and perfect and righteous. Okay? So today, close your eyes and repeat this prayer after me. This is the prayer of repentance. Say after me. Loving Father.
Loving Father.
I thank you.
You brought us together.
For this water baptism.
We believe in you.
What you have done.
I want to do it.
We want to do it.
Before doing,
we ask you to forgive us.
Of all our sins.
Knowingly, unknowingly,
whatever
we have committed
against your word and teachings,
whatever sins
I have committed,
Lord forgive me,
wash me
with the blood of Jesus,
cleanse me
with the blood of Jesus,
make me righteous,
make me perfect.
I shall obey the full image of what I have.
This shall bring power for me.
This shall bring the Holy Ghost.
Lord. The fire of the Holy Spirit. My life shall be victorious. Help me, guard me, guide me.
Bless me, guide me.
And lead me in my life. In Jesus' almighty name. I pray.
I pray.
In Jesus' almighty name.
Jesus' almighty name.
We pray.
We pray.
And let's shout.
Amen.
One more time.
Amen.
One more time.
Amen.
One more time.
Amen.
Today I have an announcement saying that Sister Elizabeth and Brother Paulus is here. Paulus, who was totally unconscious, the doctor said he will not live. Doctor said he will not live. This Paulus was totally unconscious. And Sister, where is Sukeshi? Sukeshi. Kya bola tha doctor isko?
Isko bola tha.
4 days time was given for Paulus. Paulus, no?
Yes.
4 days for that he will not live. But God has made him to live. Amen. After that, his right leg and right leg. He started walking. He started walking. He started living. See, the life is given to us by God.
Amen. Yes.
Even if I pray, if you become all right, don't think that because of pastor's prayer. No, it is God's will that you shall live.
Hallelujah.
It's God's will that you shall be healed.
Amen.
It's God's will that you shall take the word of Ephraim tonight.
Amen.
I'm glad about all these children. Let us pray for the water. Remember at the Bethesda pool, what happened? At the Bethesda pool, the angel is to come and stir up the water. Whoever gets into the water full will be healed.
Amen.
That time, the man was lying there for 38 long years. Nobody was there to push him in the water. But Jesus came and healed him. Today we are praying for the water to be struck by the angels. But Jesus is already here to heal everyone.
Amen.
Let everyone save our souls.
Amen.
Lord Jesus, we thank you, Lord. We give all the praise and glory and honor. All of us, we pray together.
Amen.
This water shall be turned into the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
This water shall turn into the blood of Jesus, a healing water. Everyone, those who come in, their soul, spirit, and body shall be healed.
Amen.
Jesus, almighty name we pray.
Amen.
I have decided.
I decided to follow Jesus. I have decided, no turning back, no turning back.
No turning back,
no turning back.
Don't go with me.
Don't go with me. Just let me follow. Don't go with me.
I still will
follow, though none go with me. I still will follow, no turning back, no turning back, no turning back, no turning back.
One more time, I just want to tell the testimony. He was totally unconscious. He was in coma in Mubarak Hospital and the doctors had given up hope. And after the prayers of Brother Francis and his wife and his children and myself, God raised him up and he is alive today.
Amen.
He was not walking, but after the prayers he started walking little by little.
Amen.
And today it's a wonderful decision. This body will go to the grave, but the soul has to be remembered.
Amen.
Where the soul will go. And he has made a good decision of taking the water option, because sure, the soul will go into the kingdom of
heaven.
Yes. Laws and commandments of God. चलेगा ऐसा थोड़ा अपना ओके और बंद करो तुम्हारा पैर कितने इधर पकड़ लिया मत से ऐसा पकड़ ना पकड़ ना पकड़ अच्छा मैं अंदर डाल देता अंदर जाने का कोई डरने का नहीं है टुडे बिलीव दैट ही शैल बी हील टुडे बिलीव दैट गॉड शैल हील
टुडे
बिलीव द होली स्पिरिट ऑफ गॉड शैल हील लेट द सी द फेथ द फॉलोस नाउ वी ऑल बैप्टाइज हिम इन द नेम ऑफ द फादर एंड ऑफ द सन एंड ऑफ द होली स्पिरिट Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Father, we
thank you. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this, your son, Father God. God is no more the old man. He's buried, Father God. Surely heaven and angels are all rejoicing, Father, for this soul that has been saved, Father God. Surely. And he's come out as a new creation, Father God. Father, we pray in the name of Jesus. Lord Jesus, baptism with the fire, Father God.
Amen.
And then the Holy Spirit of God shall fill him. The power of God shall fill him. And every bones, every muscles, every tissue, the entire body shall be washed and cleansed by the blood of Jesus. Yes, Father God. We thank you for this way, Father God, that is put unto you, Lord Jesus. And we pray that the entire life that was right now, from today on, Father God, he and his entire household shall be saved because
amen,
of
amen,
the
great
testimony that you have healed him,
that
you delivered him, Father God. Thank you, Father, for your presence, Father God. Thank you for the Holy Spirit of God, Father God. Thank you. We give all the glory and honor and praises. In Jesus' name we pray and ask.
Amen. Father, we thank you, Lord, for blessing Paulo and filling him with the Holy Ghost. He shall follow the word, laws, commandments, and teaching. His life shall be victorious. Thank you for making him a new man. Let the Holy Ghost work in his life. In Jesus' almighty name we pray.
Amen.
I have decided.
I have decided to follow Jesus.
Have you accepted Jesus as your personal Savior and Lord? Okay? Which was there? What was there? Oh, very good. She said, I have belief in the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. So you are going to follow the word of God and read the laws, commandments, and teachings and follow?
Yes.
Yes. And are you going to have the fellowship like this only with the brothers, those who are born again, and the Bible believing church? Thank you, Jesus, Violet. I praise you, adore you, worship you for the dedication that you are doing tonight. And all the other brothers and everybody, as we are stretching forth our hands towards you, you shall receive the power of the Holy Ghost as you are going down. And today we baptize you because of your faith in the name of the Father and of the Son, Jesus Christ, and of the Holy Spirit of God. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Very good. Very good. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody pray. Somebody pray.
Almighty God, we thank you,
Jesus.
Father, for this day.
Yes, sir.
Lord, the heavens rejoice.
Thank you, Jesus.
Because Sister Violet has received
amen.
Jesus in her heart, willingly, without any force. Lord, she is convicted. Lord, from this day onwards, she will take control of her life. Everything she does, she shall be guided
amen.
By
amen.
The
amen. Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Jesus.
Greater
amen.
For her life and her family. Father, we thank you, Lord. This is the greatest day in her life. Lord, let her remember that God has saved her from because of his saving grace. She's received Jesus in her heart. Lord, we thank you. We make this prayer in the name of Almighty Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. Father, we thank you, Lord, for Sister Violet. Bless her in the name of Jesus. Fill her with the Holy Ghost and power. Use her for with your glory and honor. She shall be a great testimony until she reaches heaven. In Jesus' almighty name we pray.
Amen.
The cross before me.
The cross before me,
the wall behind me. The cross before me,
the wall behind me. The cross before me, the wall behind me. No turning back, no turning back.
Ruben, have you believed in the Lord Jesus Christ tonight? Have you accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior? Have you repented for all your sins? Have you decided to read the word of God, follow the laws, commandments and teachings?
Yes.
Oh yes, seeing your faith and dedication to the Lord Jesus Christ. And now we all baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son, Jesus Christ, and of the Holy Spirit of God. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Very good. Hallelujah. Somebody please pray, some altar.
Loving Father, we surrender Reuben in your holy mighty hands.
Amen. Amen. Power of God.
Word, my master.
Power of the Holy Ghost. Power of the Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost shall rest
your life shall be great. Your power of God.
Give him a
Holy
new
God.
Heart.
Holy Ghost.
My master. Hallelujah.
Thank
Lord,
you, Lord.
Today onwards, Lord, he shall be more committed, Lord. To
amen. 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 Amen.
Righteousness, Lord, my master. He help him to be an overcomer, Lord, from the lust of the eyes, lust of the world, and pride of life,
amen.
Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. He shall read the word of God. know more of truth, Lord, and walk in a perfect heart, my master, and shall be a perfect vessel, Lord, for the extension of your kingdom. He shall be a soul winner, my master. He and his family and his generation shall be blessed, Lord. Let the name of the Lord be glorified. Hallelujah, Lord. We bless your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Amen. The Lord is showing he is going to be a totally separated boy in the family.
Hallelujah.
Separated boy in the family. He will be doing his own thing for the Lord, and he will be doing his own things for his studies. God is going to give him very much intellectual mind.
Amen.
What was his last course?
86%.
Thereafter you will see the wisdom is increased. God has blessed him. Lord, I thank you. You have chosen him. We give all the praise. Fill him with the power of God and use him for your glory and honor. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus.
Have you accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior?
Yes.
Have you decided to walk according to the laws, commandments and teachings of God? Have you dedicated your life to read the word and go for a fellowship when the Bible believing church is there?
Yes.
Shall us sing your decision and your faith. Now be all of you as a church of Elam baptize you because of your faith in the name of the Father and of the Son Jesus Christ and of the Holy Spirit of God. Amen. Yes. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Amen. What's your feeling? Thank you, Lord. Yeah, come on, somebody pray.
Father, as this is a new beginning for this sister of us, Father God.
Amen.
Father God, let this beginning, Father God, be a new birth to her, O Lord Jesus, so that she shall come into that eternal life,
yes.
Lord Jesus. Father God, we pray, Father God, that the heavens are open for her, O Lord.
Mother is here.
Yes. Father God, as she decided and convicted to take this water baptism, yes, Father God, we believe in our heart, Father God, that everything has become new, Father God. All the old things have gone away, Father God. The old thing has been buried, Father God, and she is going to come into the newness of life, O Lord Jesus. Father God, though she is in the world, Lord Jesus, but she is not of this world, O Lord Jesus, but she belongs to you, O Lord Jesus, and every decision that she has made, O Lord, Father God, it is a perfect decision, Father God, for winning souls to salvation, O Lord Jesus. Father God, as she proceeds with her life, O Lord Jesus, help her, Father God, to give new words, Father God, the word from your Bible, Father God, to the near and dearer ones, O Lord Jesus, so that they also shall be saved, O Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Increase her faith into you, O Lord Jesus, and let her be anointed by the power of the Holy Spirit, O Lord Jesus, and let Holy Spirit take control of her, O Lord. We thank you, Father God, for you have heard this prayer and you have blessed this sister of ours. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen. Amen. Those who are here, let them hear what the Spirit of God is doing tonight.
Amen.
Oh, Rabba, Riba, Bari, Baba, Riba, Bari, Kaba, Da, La, La, La. Three manner of blessings of God has declared upon our life. Number one, the generational curse of parents are broken. There is nothing but the blessing upon our life. God is going to use her in a very different manner and a very different way, and she will be blessed, and she will be a blessing to many young sons and young daughters. Oh, Rabba, Riba, Bari, Baba, Rika, Bada, La, La, La. In our life, she is not going to see sorrows, pain and agony. Trials will be there. Something is happening. Something is happening. Oh, ra, 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 ra. Oh, Rabba, Riba, Bari, Baba, Rika, Bada, La, La, La. Trials will be there, tribulation will be there, suffering will be there, but God is making you to stand, and you are victorious, you are successful. Great asset of God, great power of God, every comfort, every blessing, God is promising you. Your life is going to be fruitful. Understand fruitful? Yes, in every area of your life you will bear fruit. God is blessing you. Receive the blessing of God. Power of God is touching you. Then Jesus Almighty name we pray.
Amen.
I have decided.
I have decided to follow Jesus.
Thank you for coming. When did you take the water baptism? 12 years before. Alright, when did you take the water baptism? Pardon?
Not yet.
Oh, today you can make a decision. Both your daughters, your wife is born again. You should also join them in the kingdom of heaven. It should not be that all our family members are going and we remain here. Alright? It's a wonderful decision, wonderful decision, wonderful decision. Rian, have you accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior?
Yes.
Okay. Have you decided to walk behind Jesus Christ as a child of God?
Yes.
Have you decided to follow the rules and regulations, laws, commandments, teaching according to the Holy Bible?
Yes.
Have you decided to go to the fellowship where the Bible believing church is there and to have a fellowship there? Seeing your faith, we want to baptize you. In the name of the Father and of the Son, Jesus Christ, and of the Holy Spirit of God. Completely go down. Amen. Very good. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody please pray. Yes, somebody.
Almighty Father, Lord,
thank you.
Praise you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. When you receive the Holy Spirit, you shall receive power. You shall be a testimony to me in Judea and Samaria and uttermost parts of the world.
Amen.
And I pray, Lord, she shall be a testimony to you, Lord. You shall use her for your glory and honor, Almighty Father. Your kingdom shall be in her, Almighty Father.
Jesus.
She shall be blessed and anointed in every area of her life, Almighty
Amen.
I pray the gifts of the Holy Spirit, Lord, word of
God,
word of wisdom, speaking
Amen.
Of tongue, interpretation of
Amen.
God, Lord, discernment of
Amen.
The Spirit, gift of prophecy, Lord, healing. Faith shall work in her, Almighty Father, Lord. And she shall be a blessed child to her parents,
Thank
Lord,
you,
everybody, Lord. And in your name, she shall cast out demons, heal the sick, and Lord, fulfill your great commission.
Hallelujah.
Thank you for her obedience, Lord. And we pray that the blessing shall follow from today onwards, Father, Lord. And be with her. This we ask the Father in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen.
God is going to use you. You're not going to be in this country anymore. God is going to take you to the another country. Where you will go, but you will shine. All manner of support will come to you. You are miraculously receiving some type of benefit that is called, what you call that?
Scholarship.
And with that you will be surprised because somebody is coming and meeting you in regards to this also. It's rarely it happens, but you are a peculiar child. Because you have chosen the Lord Jesus, He has also chosen you to be blessed. And you will be blessed and you will see the reward of God in your life. A special wisdom, a special knowledge of God will continue. You will be shining with the wisdom and knowledge of God, with word, with profession, and your life will be blessed. Receive all your blessings. Say, I receive it. I receive it. In Jesus' name. Amen. Jesus, thank you, Lord. The cross before me, the world behind me. The cross before me, the world behind me. My sister has made a wonderful decision. The summit has sent to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And she has come. What decision she has made, she is going to receive great blessings of God. Let us give a big hand of praise. Sister Usha, have you accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior?
Yes.
Have you repented for your sins?
Yes.
Have you decided to walk after the Lord Jesus according to the laws, commandments and teachings?
Yes.
Will you continue in having the fellowship with the righteous and with the people of God in a right manner?
Yes.
Will you go for the fellowship where the Bible believing church is having similar type of praise, worship and glory of God is going on? Will you go there?
Yes.
Alright. Seeing your faith, we all baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son Jesus Christ and of the Holy Spirit of God.
Yes.
Hand us to go. Keep your hand like this. Yeah. Okay, cover this. And hold your nose. Thank you, Jesus. Seeing your faith and acceptance of Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, we baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Keep your hand down. Yes. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody please pray.
Loving Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for Sister Usha, Lord Father. We thank you, Lord Father. Father God, as the heaven is rejoicing
thank
today, Lord
Jesus.
Father, because our name is written in
Amen.
The book of life, Lord Father, we thank you, Lord.
Don't worry, you are
Father
filling
God,
with the power of God.
Lord,
this
Father,
is that fire.
Lord,
this is that fire that we feel. The power of the fire of God. This is that fire that the Lord is speaking about. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Fire of God. Fill us with the fire of God.
Amen.
What are you seeing, Sister Usha?
Clouds.
You are seeing clouds?
Yeah.
All around.
And something is robed person.
Somebody who is robed in the clothes.
Yeah, robed
is
in the clothes.
Is he coming down? Is he coming down?
Yeah.
Where is he?
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Fill up more with the Holy Spirit.
Jesus.
Yes, yes. Come on, all of us, let's all say, we love you, Jesus.
We love you, Jesus.
We love you, Jesus.
We love you, Jesus.
We love you, Jesus. In the name of
Jesus.
We love you, Jesus.
We love you, Jesus.
Thank you for being with us, Lord. Lord, we pray, fill us all with the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
And fill us with that love. Because from heaven you came down to see every one of us because of your love upon our lives.
Amen.
We thank you, Holy Spirit of God.
Amen.
We thank you, Jesus, for your love, your love, your love.
Amen.
We thank you, Lord. This is acceptable in thy sight, and therefore you left your heavenly throne and you came down because you love all of us, and especially Sister Ucha and her family. We give all the praise and good honors. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
That cross before me,
the one behind me.
Keep on praying.
The cross before me, the one behind me. The cross before me, the one behind me. No turning back, no turning back.
Are you happy to take the word of God?
I'm very happy.
Very nice. Very nice. This is the blessings of God for you. God is blessing you. And you and your husband, Brother Nidal, life will be totally changed. God is going to do new things in your family life. New things. All the sorrows and pain and agony is going to go away. Just believe. Yusuf, have you accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior?
Yes.
Have you believed in the Lord Jesus Christ?
Yes.
Have you repented for your sins?
Yes.
Have you decided to walk according to the word, laws and commandments of God?
Yes.
Have you decided to have the fellowship with the born again brothers and sisters like this?
Yes.
Seeing your faith and acceptance of Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, we all want to baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son, Jesus Christ, and of the Holy Spirit of God. Keep your hands down. Yes, keep this one like this. Thank you, Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, somebody please pray. Pray for the Holy Spirit of God to fill him.
Abba, Father, we thank you, Lord. Lord, you said, ask, we shall receive.
Thank you, Jesus.
We shall find, knock, it shall be opened to you.
Amen.
Lord, today we ask the Holy Spirit of God, take control.
Fill him, with the power of God.
With the power of God. Lord, we
thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. The Holy Spirit.
Lord, you
power of God, power of God, power of God.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Heaven is filled with Yusuf. Yusuf's name is written in the book of life. Lord, we thank you for enabling him, encouraging him, and taking care of him.
Is watching. Hallelujah.
Lord, from this day onwards, he shall be a changed person, totally different, away from the worldly matters.
Amen.
Lord, you take control of every situation in his life. Lord, he shall be the leader. Today we declare that he shall lack nothing, because we know that he is the child of God. Lord, we thank you, Lord, through him, he shall work for the kingdom of God and he shall be blessed. Thank you, Father. We make this prayer in the name of Almighty Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. When Joseph was given the dream and the vision, he knew what he is going to become. So also when Daniel had a vision and dreams, God spoke to him what he is going to become. And when Moses was with the people of the Israel, God told him, you are going to be a great deliverer. Similar type of anointing is going to rest upon you. Position God is going to give you. Power God is going to give you. And God is going to use you to deliver many other people. Many young sons and daughters, those who are with a similar background, will come to the knowledge of God. God is anointing you. Some little light, and now it is increasing in the name of the Lord. Some light is coming from heaven. That light is shining upon you. In that light you shall see the glory of God. That light is the light of King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He will never walk in darkness. He will always shine upon you as a light. And when the light is come, all the darknesses are gone. He blessed you so. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
So what did you see? Light you saw, and just the light increasing. What do you call in Arabic? Brother Nidal?
Noor.
Okay, praise God. God bless you. Congratulations.
Thank you,
Lord. When they come here by the Holy Spirit of God, they are shaking. But I'm seeing his body and I'm shaking. Anyway, it is a practical. It is a practical thing. But it is so nice that he has dedicated his life to the Lord Jesus Christ. Such a Esther, have you received Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior?
Yes.
Nobody said anything from your family because you are coming and obeying the order of baptism?
No, I didn't tell anybody.
No, you did not tell anybody? I see. Okay, so it's an open challenge. It's an open challenge. We can tell that. Later also you can say and you can inform your family members. Declare what God has done in your life. This is not the work of yours or mine. This is God's calling for you. Have you accepted Jesus as a Lord and Savior?
Yes.
Have you repented for your sins?
Yes.
Have you decided to walk behind the cross as well as laws, commandments and teachings of God?
Yes.
See, it will be a temptation when you go back to your country, city or wherever you go. Will you be able to follow the fellowship like this with the born again?
Yes.
You must. Lord Jesus will protect you and guard and guide you. Seeing your faith, we baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son, Jesus Christ, and of the Holy Spirit God. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Father, for this brother, Father God, who has accepted you as a Lord and your Savior, Father. He is no more that old Nestor. He is a new Nestor, Father. Surely heaven are rejoicing, Father God.
Amen.
He shall never walk the same way as he walked before, Father God. He shall make acquaintance with new people, with the believers, Father. He shall fellowship with the people of God, Father God. Everything, and he shall be used mightily in the days to come, Father God. Equip him by the power of the Holy Spirit. The gifts of the Holy Spirit and the fruit of the Holy Spirit shall operate in his life, Father. He shall never before be the same, Father. Every wherever he goes, whatever he does, the name of the Lord shall be glorified.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord, use him as a tongue talker, soul winner, and a demon driver, Father God. Oh, yes, Father, protect and preserve and prosper him in every area of his life, Father. Yes, Father, so also bless his family and all the others. Next up, his extended members of the family shall come to the knowledge of the saving grace of our Lord Jesus Christ through him, Father God. Oh, yes, Father, let the power of God, the fire of God, Jesus, you baptize him with the fire of God, Father God, so that he shall be used for your kingdom, Father God. Thank you, Father, you have heard and granted our prayers. In Jesus' most precious name, we have bidden our
prayer. Amen. Nestor, watch. God is going to give you the gift to talk to your individual families. You will have a word for every brother, every sister that God has given unto you. It looks like you are the one who has separated from the family. And many ladies are there in your family. How many brothers you all have? How many brothers you all have? You are alone. You are the only one brother. How many sisters you all have?
Two.
So God is going to use you in a very special way. And God is going to bless you with that anointing. When you speak, they will be able to understand and they will be convicted. The special power of God is going to come upon you and God is going to use you. And this will be for the glory of God and the power of God. In your life you shall be a special and dedicated man for the glory of God. You are asking for the Lord to give you a new life. Today every curse upon your family is broken. Every curse in your flesh is broken. Every curse in the family, the land problem, the property problem, the evil problems, all are gone. All the devil codes are broken in the name of Jesus. You are a new man in the name of Jesus Christ. God's Holy Spirit is touching you. God's power is resting upon you. God's glory is coming upon you. Your son is filled with the Holy Spirit.
Jesus
almighty name we pray.
Yeah.
Father, I pray in the name of Jesus we all pray. Is the last one?
Yes.
Lord, we all pray together that whatever touches he has on his body, nothing shall work against his spirit and soul. It shall not bother him, but he shall be under the blood of Jesus and victorious life. Your life is going to be changed. Your job, God, is going to change. Your salary, God, is going to change. Everything is going to become higher. And step by step, it will come to you. Be blessed. Be anointed. In Jesus' almighty name we pray.
Yeah.
Faith in the name of
Jesus.
Faith in the blood of
Jesus.
Faith in the name of
Jesus.
I decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back.
Go with me.
No longer with me. Yes, I will follow. No longer with me. Yes, I will follow. No longer with me. Yes, I will follow. No turning back. No turning back.
No turning back.
No turning back.
No turning back.
No turning back.
Thank you. He also saw the light. What exactly? Tell the people.
I saw full light with golden, like rainbows.
Okay.
Like rainbow color in the light.
Alright. Rainbow represented no more distraction. Light represented no more darknesses. The light is going to be full of the Holy Spirit of God. These are the signs of the Holy Spirit. Visions, revelations, dreams, word of God. Through all this, God is speaking to you and blessing you. God bless you. Congratulations. Thank you, Jesus. Let's all thank now. Father, we thank you, Lord. We call the praise and good honor all the families, those who are gathered here. Every one of them, those who came here, Lord. You fill them with the power of God. Fill them with the blessings of God. Every brother, every sister, every husband, every wife, every individual shall receive the power of God and the blessings of God in their life. And all shall be successful. Any of the mothers, any of the fathers, those who are waiting for their sons and daughters to come into the kingdom of God, bless them. Bless them, bless them. They shall see this joyful day for their sons and daughters and husbands and wives, and they all shall be saved, Lord. We give all the praise and glory and honor. Without you, it is impossible. Because of you, all these children are in the kingdom of God. We give all the praise and glory and honor. In Jesus' almighty name we pray.
Amen.
Written in the name of
Jesus.
Written in the blood of
Jesus.
Written in the word of
Jesus.
Let us give a big hand of praise to you.